You are listening to Larry Connors, USA.
You want answers?
I think I'm entitled.
You want answers?
I want the truth!
You can't handle the truth!
This is Larry Connors, USA. Larry Connors, USA. Larry Connors, USA, news and commentary.
July 16, 2021, President Biden stating, and I'm quoting him, "Communism is a failed system, a universally failed system, and I don't see socialism as a very useful substitute." As I have suggested, we'll get into it in more detail in the next segment. There is the 25th Amendment to the Constitution to remove the president, and the vice president then becomes president. If you're going to enact and use the 25th Amendment, the vice president has to sign off on it. And if Biden is beginning to talk out and speak out against communism and socialism, which the progressive left says that's the way we should take this nation, they may well be considering, you know, he really is a little lost, so let's just move him out now. Oh, and Biden also said, I'm considering establishing an internet source for the Cuban people. Remember, the Cuban communist government shut down their internet system. So we're really not getting any current, immediate reports of what's happening in Cuba, especially those protesting. So he's going to give them an internet source. While at the same time, the White House is working with Facebook and others to flag and shut down information the White House considers fake and not good or just needs to be shut down. Yes, yes, they've admitted that. We spent a lot of time on that in the last segment. White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki just flat out saying, yes, we often flag things to Facebook for them to take down. The White House controlling Facebook, that is nothing short of censorship. I mean, that, as Senator Josh Hawley, Republican of Missouri, said, I think it's really scary to have the federal government, the White House, compiling a list of people, organizations, then going to a private company and saying you need to censor. He is right. He's right about that. And part of the issue involves, since they're talking about coronavirus, that the White House says, false information gets out there. We need to shut it down. Well, where are you going to clear false information? Like when Trump was telling the truth that this virus probably came out of the lab, and all the others were saying, no, he's stupid again. It didn't come out of the lab. And Dr. Fake said, no way. And now 180 degrees difference, it could be. And in fact, the director general of the World Health Organization now begging China to cooperate with the investigation into the origins of coronavirus. The very organization under his leadership that said it's not that bad. And how did they know? Well, that's what China told them, and they just parroted it. You know, they're members of the squad. Now they got another one, the boy guy. They got, squad has to be infiltrated too. It can't just all be women. AOC leading all the women. Now, Congressman Jamal Bowman, Democrat in New York, he's set to introduce a Green New Deal for public schools. It will cost $1.4 trillion. Climate Capital Facilities Grants for schools. That's going to really help educate the kids, right? Oh, by the way, Treasury Secretary Yellen says, this child tax credit of $250 to $300 per child every month under the Biden administration should be made permanent. You do that, you're going to have even more people not bothering to go to work. And later in this hour, we're going to be joined by one of the owners of Cafe Napoli in the St. Louis area about, again, how difficult it is to find folks to work as it is. You're going to continue to send these checks out, and there's a report that verifies folks will just say, no, thanks, I'll just stay at home. We'll get into that later. I do want to make sure you're aware that a Lubbock County Sheriff's deputy was shot and killed during a SWAT standoff in the West Texas city of Levelland yesterday. That's near Lubbock, Texas, if you have any idea. It's just another assault on police. Two other deputies also shot, listed in critical condition. In the meantime, in Oklahoma, two Republican combat veterans who ran for local office on a Back the Blue campaign message have flipped the left-wing city council seats in Norman, Oklahoma. Yes, it's clear defunding police is not a good idea for anyone at any time unless you're against them. And then you're all for it. By all means, get rid of the police. They would love it.
Larry Connors, USA, news and commentary.
For years, I've told you, be well with Wellington. Wellington Environmental. That's because I know the excellent work Wellington does when it comes to making your home, your business, even hospitals safe. See, recently I asked Wellington to check a relative's home. The relative had been constantly sick. Doctors couldn't find a cause. I asked Tom Wellington, please check the house. After extensive testing, Wellington could rule out mold and other air and water toxins. Well, that was a major relief, and the negative results gave doctors added information. So when I encourage you to call Wellington, I mean it. Wellington, 314-644-4930. 644-4930. A-rated by the Better Business Bureau, Missouri and Illinois. Wellington Environmental, 314-644-4930. Be well with Wellington. Wellington Environmental.
I want to thank my friends at John Bill Roofing for sponsoring this segment of Larry Connors USA. John Bill Roofing, covering homes, businesses throughout the Midwest with the best quality, lowest price. John Bill Roofing. Call 1-800-NEW-ROOF. 1-800-NEW-ROOF.
And we're down, we go.
This is Larry Connors, USA.
Larry Connors, USA.
Communism is a fail system, universally fail system. And I don't see socialism as a very useful substitute, but that's another story. Cuba is unfortunately, a failed state in repressing their citizens.
Those are the words of President Biden. Let me repeat them for you again, because that's a very strong admission. A very strong admission from President Biden, who got in with the help of the far left because they expected he was going to be a lot more left than what he was campaigning on. They thought, okay, he's got to walk the line. He's got to kind of keep some moderates, but he's going to be our puppet. We're going to pull the strings. I'm not sure they're still not pulling the strings, but here you have him flat out saying, maybe somebody didn't check his speech. You think he just got up and made that remark on his own? That I doubt. No, I don't think he made it on his own. But he said communism is a failed system, a universally failed system, and that Cuba is unfortunately a failed state repressing their citizens. Did he just now wake up to that fact? Of course, Cuba is just 90 miles off our shore. And yes, Trump imposed sanctions on them that Obama had opened up because they were still oppressing people and they still were not doing what they should be doing. And then COVID came. And the White House, even though you have Biden making that statement, they're still trying to induce and state that, well, COVID is really behind it, which means, therefore, Trump is involved and part of the issue. The Castros controlled Cuba for 60-plus years. Fidel, then his brother Raul, and then this last April, a new communist leader came in. And I think at that point, the people began to say, you know what? This is the time. This is the time. So they started protesting in the streets, all thousands all across Cuba. First, we're getting reports of two or three cities, then 10 cities, and then 20 cities, and then maybe more cities. And many of them waving and carrying the USA flag, shouting freedom. Sandra Cruz said the other day, they weren't shouting COVID, give me a COVID vaccine. They weren't shouting, give me food or give me water. They were just shouting freedom. That's what they want. Of course, we don't have any information coming out of there now, immediate. And because the communist government is taking a good hint of what to do from, dare I say it? Of course I dare say it. They're taking a clue from the White House, the Biden White House, and how it's getting and working with Facebook to censor anything or anyone they don't like. Yeah, I said it. And, of course, North Korea does the same thing. So does China. We don't know a lot what goes on if they don't want it. And in this case, they shut down the Internet for Cuba. The folks, the Cuban government shut it down. So here's Biden said, I'm going to try to help out. I'm considering establishing an Internet source for the Cuban people. Is he going to do that for former President Trump? Is he going to do that for those who are in Facebook jail right now because Facebook didn't like something they said, or because somebody at the White House said, we need to flag that. That's a dangerous statement or fake or whatever. Jen Psaki, the White House staff, admitted as much, and we'd spent a lot of time on it in the previous hour. If you missed it, I do encourage you to go back and listen to it on the podcast. But now Biden says, what I'm going to try to do is help get an Internet. That's not going to bring them freedom. We'll begin to get information out of there. But even later, as Jen Psaki followed up on Biden's remarks, where Biden just admits communism fails, it doesn't work, Psaki is already trying to spin it.
Now that you've had a few days to think about it, does this White House still think the protests in Cuba are happening because people are upset about a rise in COVID cases there, or is there some thought maybe given to the possibility that they are protesting because they are sick of communism?
Well, Peter, first I would say communism is a failed ideology, and we certainly believe that. It has failed the people of Cuba. They deserve freedom.
So even she admitted it because the boss said it. Yeah, in that answer to Fox News, Peter Ducey, when he said you've had several days to think about it, because in the beginning, the White House was saying, well, you got to keep in mind people were upset because there's shortages of food and water and vaccines. We do not, let me repeat and emphasize to you, this nation does not, never has, stopped humanitarian aid to those in need. In fact, we have often led the charge to bring in humanitarian aid. Even for countries that we don't like, we have no relationships with, we're doing it for the people if it gets to the actual victims and not the ones at the top only. But he was asking, Peter Ducey saying, you were saying they're all upset about the COVID cases. That's part of it. Are you now believing that they are just sick of communism? Well, Peter, first I'd say communism is a failed ideology. We certainly believe it. It failed the people of Cuba. They deserve freedom. But they're already trying to hide the fact that, it can't be all that. And yet, maybe they've opened that box up too far. We have heard nothing from the squad, the progressive liberals in the Congress, about Cuba, Senator Sanders got grabbed for a question on the run saying, what about Cuba? And he said, well, I'm all for the Cuban people having, freedom and so forth. But he's also still for the Cuban government. You can't be both because the Cuban government is not for the people. It oppresses the people. Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez finally broke her silence referenced Cuba. And here's what she wrote. We stand in solidarity with the Cuban people and condemn. Please, as I read this, do not gag and get really sick on me. Please. So let me finish the statement and give me a moment. Just don't go wacko just yet. She says, we stand in solidarity with the Cuban people and condemn the suppression of the media. Warning bell, warning bell. Speech, warning, and protest. Whoa. She issues that statement right after the White House press secretary acknowledges suppression of the media speech in working with Facebook, shutting down anyone they don't like or they don't think they're telling them what should be said. But then AOC also goes forward and says, we also call for an end to the U.S. embargo and additional Trump-era restrictions that are profoundly contributing to the suffering of Cubans. Stop it right there. Once again, it's another lie, but you're not going to see Facebook or Twitter call it out. She's trying again to suggest U.S. embargo is responsible for the people in the street. I told you, and Senator Cruz had stated the other day, they're not out there yelling food, water. They're not even hollering, we need COVID vaccines. Cuba refused to take in vaccines from other countries, saying we'll do our own. 11 million on that island, only 15% vaccinated. So, yeah, there's an issue. But they have trade relations with other countries. They just did a deal with Venezuela. There is food and water available, but that always goes to the top, not those down below. They'll give them just enough. AOC, of course, was not going to say, as you heard Biden say a moment ago, communism is a failed system, and I don't see socialism as a very useful substitute. You don't see her agreeing with that. She does say Cuba's suppression of media, speech, and protests are, quote, gross violations of civil rights. Well, at least she acknowledges that, but not reference what's happening in the U.S. right now. Senator Ted Cruz from the Senate floor.
Madam President, I rise today to discuss the protests we've seen erupt in Cuba over the past several days. On Sunday, shouts of libertad, freedom, were heard in dozens of cities and towns all over Cuba as people took to the streets to protest the communist government that has had a stranglehold on that nation for 62 years. This socialist regime has tortured, killed, silenced, denied freedom, and driven into exile generations of Cubans.
And his family being one of them. His father in the 90s got his family out of Cuba and to the U.S. of A. We are a beacon on the hill for many oppressed people around the world, be they under communism, Marxism, or bad conditions because the government won't take care of them properly. And yet we have so many in this country constantly denouncing the nation, the anthem, the flag. A recent poll coming out saying that many young people just don't think America is that good. They have no basis of any understanding. Do you remember being a teenager? Were you really as smart as you thought you were? Did you finally realize as you got older, your parents got smarter? But, of course, we still have in this nation also the state-controlled media that helps push the issue that the problem in Cuba is not communism. It's, as Andrea Mitchell works in, it's got to be the COVID.
Finally, I want to ask you about Cuba because I know all of the reasons for, you know, criticizing the regime right now, the president, the secretary of state, Senator Menendez, very strongly when I interviewed him the other day. But COVID has, on top of the Trump sanctions, cratered their economy. Should we find ways to do more for the Cuban people and for relaxing some of the Trump restrictions on remittances, wire transfers that go to families back home?
Andrea, earlier today I met with Governor David Beasley, who runs the World Food Program. He won the Nobel Peace Prize, or the organization did, under his leadership last year. And one of the enduring questions facing something like the World Food Program is, should we be providing food relief to governments in countries like Ethiopia, North Korea, Venezuela, Syria, elsewhere, where government action is oppressing their people and causing famine? So, too, is the case with Cuba. A country where long-standing communist authoritarian regime repression of their people has created the conditions, in combination with our sanctions and with COVID, for a popular uprising.
Yeah, again, they got to tie COVID in. Those are the words of Senator Coons, Democrat, buying in. Yeah, COVID contributing. And, of course, COVID, any issue of that has to be traced back to Trump. And, of course, we have other communist nations, and the people are suffering, too, and we do have trade relations with them. So you could make a case, since we have trade relations with China and so forth, that maybe we should reopen with Cuba, but they won't acknowledge the fact. They just won't acknowledge facts, period. Coming up, many Americans in a new survey say, no, thank you, I'll just take my government money and stay at home instead of going to work. One of the owners of Cafe Napoli will join us talking about how, again, it's still affecting hiring. Stand by.
You can connect with Larry on Twitter at Larry Connors USA.
This is Larry Connors USA. Larry Connors USA.
The week ending June 19, there were 14 million adults who were getting unemployment benefits. That's the most recent estimated total recipients from both state and federal programs. 14 million. Morning Consult just did a survey, just released, and found that more than 7 million didn't take a job offer because they're getting generous unemployment benefits. So why work? My next guest, and always I want to be transparent with you, Cafe Napoli is a sponsor of this program, but I've had and of course relationship with the owner Tony Piatoso and his sons over the last several years, and we had interviewed one of them previously, Kai Piatoso, of one of the locations, about the difficulty of hiring employees. And I want to see where we stand today based on that report I just read to you. Joining us now is Andy Piatoso of Napoli. Welcome aboard, Andy.
Thank you, Larry. Appreciate it.
So tell me what you're seeing. Your brother had told me about a month ago that it's hurting several restaurants and other businesses in the area. Where does it stand now? Gotten any better?
So we were really excited June 17th when that came, because we thought that we were going to, you know, get a whole bunch of applicants and people, you know, quality applicants to come in and apply. And so what has happened since then is we've gotten a lot of people to apply. There has been an uptake in people applying, but when I reach out to set up an interview, they don't come, they don't respond, they don't show up. So that's the big issue. So it hasn't gotten any better at all.
Some of these surveyed, when they asked why they turned it down, they said, not attractive economically. In other words, I'm getting more money by staying at home. Well, are you getting any specific reasons?
No, I'm not. And I mean, they definitely would make more money if they came here than they would at home. That's for sure. I don't understand where they're going or what they're doing.
Well, these government programs continue. I mean, and in fact, I see your brother is down in Miami, and he said they're seeing the same problem still with Miami Fort Lauderdale restaurants. And this is a ripple effect. It's not just your restaurants, it's your suppliers, everyone else related that circle restaurant industry, right?
Absolutely, it is. I mean, we have trouble getting lots of different wine and liquor products, food products, everything is delayed. I mean, it's unbelievable. And the ones that that are taking the jobs, you know, the few quality applicants that come in for interview, it's pretty sad. It's pretty much if they show up, they're going to get hired. And if they don't start making money right away, or something happens at the job that they don't think is they're not being treated fairly within their first 3 or 4 days, they'll just quit because they know they can go down the street and get hired right away.
I see. I don't know how many times I drive past various locations, and not just restaurants, but other businesses, you know, looking to hire, hiring now, come in and apply. I think there was a McDonald's down in Florida at one point that basically, or maybe it's California, put out a sign saying they were going to pay $50 just to come in and do an application. And I'm sure there are several people went in to apply, but not going to go to work there.
Right. And, you know, I'm afraid that it's going to get a lot worse before it gets better, because the one thing that I do have, I've got lots of college kids working for me right now, bussing tables, washing dishes, cocktail serving, hostessing. These kids are all going back to school in mid-August.
Sure.
So we're going to lose the 15 vacant positions I have right now are going to become 30 in about a month.
Well, is the government, you know, when people are in need and they lost jobs, the coronavirus, obviously there's a reason we all kind of shut things down, and the employees need help, the businesses needed help. In the last 20 seconds here, what do you see on the horizon?
I like I said, I think it's going to get a little bit worse before it gets better. But I think that at some point the government's going to have to, cut off all the additional funding and tell people, you know, it's time to go back to work.
All right. Andy Piatoso, Cafe Napoli, thank you for your time, sir.
Thanks, Larry. Bye-bye.
And what he just pointed out, those on unemployment are not allowed to turn down suitable jobs and keep their benefits. Wall Street Journal explaining you quit a job, refuse a job, it disqualifies you from getting unemployment. So many won't even go apply for that very reason. Coming up, another fail, and that is defunding police like the leftist progressives want to do. Many Democrats don't like that idea either. The cost of that issue coming up.
You can email Larry at LarryConnorsUSA@gmail.com. LarryConnorsUSA@gmail.com.
I'm sure many of you do enjoy entertaining guests. I mean, it's your nature to be hospitable, but we all draw the line at unwelcome guests. You know, those that come in tramping around under 6 feet, 8 feet, more. And when that happens, you do not want to delay. Call Rottler Pest Solutions immediately. Now, I started using Rottler more than 30 years ago because I wanted professionals. Rottler knows what is needed, and at the same time, will make sure that your family and pets are safe. Rottler is still family-owned and operated for 3 generations, protecting homes and businesses. 3 generations. That's impressive. So when you want to safely, expertly get rid of ants, spiders, and other critters, call Rottler Pest Solutions, 877-ROTTLER, or you can check their website, rottler.com, 877-ROTTLER, 877-ROTTLER, Rottler Pest Solutions, rottler.com.
I've been holding it so long, I've been sleeping all alone. Lord, I miss you. I've been hanging on the phone. I've been sleeping all alone. I won't kiss you.
This is Larry Connors USA.
Larry Connors USA.
As I mentioned in news and commentary earlier today, and I remind you, when you're listening to that at the beginning of this second hour, this hour, we say news and commentary. I'll make it very clear to you. I'm not just giving you news, I'm adding comments with it. Now, that's contrary to something that should be just news. I want you to understand and have no doubt that I'm framing it, selecting it, describing it, opinionating on it. It's not just facts. I don't try to hide it. I just want you to know that. Now, when I was a news anchor for 50-plus years in electronic journalism, If we ever made a statement that had any comment or analysis, then we were required either to put on the screen below us analysis, perspective, commentary, and even say it. that I am going to give an opinion on this piece. In other words, clearly identify it that it's different, because a lot of the public does have confusion. I would get calls off from time to time. Hey, I want to talk to you about that commentary you did. I said, I didn't do any commentary. Yeah, you did. I didn't do a commentary. He said, yeah, the commentary on that train crash. I said, that wasn't a commentary. It was a fact, a story of, oh, okay, well, commentary news, whatever you call it. And see, there's the issue. A lot of folks get confused with that. And the reason I'm going through that is because we have now members of the left saying, when we say defund the police, we didn't really mean it like that, and yet some of them do. And when the state-controlled media, that's right, I'm saying they're state-controlled media, and Jennifer Saski of the White House pretty much admitted as much yesterday when she talked about how the White House tells Facebook you need to flag these comments. They're false. They're filled with fiction instead of facts about COVID or whatever else they decide. But the defund the police thing is blowing up in their face. And that's what I was pointing out in news and commentary earlier, making sure you understood, as I told you about two Republican combat veterans ran for local office on a Back the Blue campaign message in Norman, Oklahoma. And how Norman, Oklahoma ever got to be leftist, I don't know, but they flipped the city council seats. And it happened because the city voters said enough of talking about defunding police. One of those newly elected said, the last straw for us was defunding of the police. A lot of folks we know were planning to leave the city. They just wanted to flee because we're turning into a socialist-type environment. We began this hour, once we moved past news and commentary, with President Biden saying, communism is a failed system. And socialism, I don't see as a replacement for it. We'll review that again before we wrap up today, because that's a very major statement from him while he's surrounded by the progressive left. And I want to emphasize to you again, there are a lot of good Democrats out there. They've always been good. You can have a difference of opinion. That's what this country's about. This program, in fact, I had one sponsor I was talking to, a sponsor candidate, and said, quite frankly, Larry, I like you, and I think a lot of people do. He said, but I do have a lot of folks who are liberal. They might not like it. I said, well, then you don't understand the program, and they don't either. Yes, I have conservative views. That is my main fabric and base, but I also have some views that fall into independent thinking, these groups called independents when they come to vote, and I even have some that would fall to liberal sides, at least liberal in the view of some far right. This program is 100% patriotism, 100% patriot. You can be any color, religion, gender, political stripe you want. If you support this nation and you believe in this nation and what we're doing, then you are patriotic and you are my target. And a bigger target now, since the major, the station that carried Rush Limbaugh for 25 plus years basically decided after his death, they had to do something, obviously, but they decided to go in an entirely different way, basically turning their back on that audience. And I know many of you that were listening to him during that time are now listening here, and I want you to know I appreciate it. And this defunding the police thing, that's another thing that's just blowing up on them, just as it did in Norman, Oklahoma, as I described. Jason Chaffetz is a U.S. representative, or was, I should say, Utah's 3rd Congressional District from 2009 until 2017. He's a Republican, also now a Fox News analyst. He wrote a piece for Fox talking about the crime spike, especially in wake of defunding. And he begins it by saying the crime spike is real. Democrats don't want to talk about it, but we're seeing consistent data out of blue cities where Black Lives Matter protesters are getting the criminal justice reforms they demanded. They don't work. He said the progressive agenda includes aggressive bail reform policies, the election appointment of lenient prosecutors, reclassification of felonies to misdemeanor crimes, establishment of sanctuary cities where criminals can safely hide. Murder rates up 25% across the board. That's according to the FBI. New York City saw shootings up 97%. Homicides up 45%. Chicago, 55% increase in shootings. Same stories in L.A., D.C., Philadelphia, Portland, Minneapolis, so forth, so on. And then you also have newly elected Missouri Congresswoman Cori Bush, who's now part of the squad, all pushing for defunding police. You don't need all the money spent on police. I told you yesterday that there's a provision now, a proposal that, we're not going to send police to some things. We'll just send a mental health expert with a paramedic, see if they can help them. God help the paramedic and the medical professional that are going in there, because they never know what, if police officers don't know what's going to happen when they walk in the door, these folks won't either. But Congresswoman Bush, joining with all the rest of them, to say shut down money for the police, we don't need it all on the police, let's spend it on this paying mental health professionals to go out. She just spent nearly $70,000 on private security over the past 3 months. $70,000 for private security. It was filed as part of the FEC records. It's nearly double what her campaign spent on private security during the first quarter of 2021. So she is spending tens of thousands of dollars on private security, a luxury most Americans can't afford, and that would include people of color. I think that Cori Bush apparently is among the privileged, would you think? She's got privileged status? Yeah, she does, and she got the money, the taxpayer money, and she spends it. You don't need as much protection. She does. That's the break point with a lot of these libs that are just too far over. There are many Democrats. I do challenge former Congressman Chaffetz, when he said Democrats don't want to talk about it. They may not want to talk about it, but there are many that vote Democrat, describe themselves as Democrat. They also don't like this. They made it very clear they don't like it. They have spoken out about it. But in some cases, you still see some inane things come down the slope from time to time. And in particular, I'm looking at a piece that my boots on the ground correspondent Andrew sent me out of Chicago. NBC Chicago did a piece, an extensive piece, that said, here's what to do if you're being carjacked, how to prevent it. Andrew simply questioned, rather than our local news producing these hand guides for everyday life in Chicago, I'd rather have the mayor's office and city council with police to address the problem. That sounds reasonable. But I'll share what NBC was trying to tell everybody as to how you need to protect yourself and watch out just in case you're going to be carjacked. And they had a man the other day in Chicago in broad daylight, 73 years old, survived Vietnam tours twice, and dies because he's fighting with these guys trying to hijack his car. He died of cardiac arrest, but they started it to that extent. So this NBC report in Chicago, if you find yourself a victim of carjacking, give up your car, leave the scene. Well, I'll agree, that's probably going to avoid verbal physical alteration. Okay, take note of the car taker's description and vehicle description if there's another one. If there's a child in the car, tell the carjacker there's a car, a child is in the car. Oh, and this one, in case you didn't know it, call 911 immediately. That they don't say, but they'll probably send someone out to counsel you and soothe you and bring you a milkshake and make you feel a little bit better. You call 911, you're not going to get a police officer if you get anybody to answer. And there are crimes in California where the police, they don't bother calling 911 anymore, stealing, thefts, and so forth, because the police aren't even going to bother going. They're not going to be, the person that they catch are not going to be prosecuted. Is this what we want in this country? The answer is a loud, repetitive no. When we come back, I want to again focus on two main things the White House has admitted. Absolutely admitted. I mean, it is should be ground shaking, but you're not seeing it on state-controlled media. It's worth re-noting. Coming up again. Stand by.
You can follow Larry on Larry Connors USA Facebook. Larry Connors USA Facebook.
And I think it's gonna be a long, long time. Touchdown brings me round and get to find. I'm not the man they think I am at home. Oh, no, no, no.
This is Larry Connors USA. Larry Connors USA.
Communism is a fail system, universally fail system. And I don't see socialism as a very useful substitute, but that's another story. Cuba is a, unfortunately, a failed state in repressing their citizens.
President Biden making it very clear he believes communism is a failed system, and socialism is not a substitute. And later, White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki added her thoughts, of course, parroting the president's line.
Communism is a failed ideology, and we certainly believe that. It has failed the people of Cuba. They deserve freedom. This has been a government, an authoritarian communist regime that has repressed its people and has failed the people of Cuba. Hence, we're seeing them in the streets.
Admitting, yes, that's why we're seeing it. But then they also still want to kind of tie in the embargo that Trump had re-emplaced after Obama had lifted it, and Biden still has not lifted again. And they want to blame COVID. Congresswoman AOC blaming, quote, the absurdly cruel, as she words it, Trump-era restrictions for causing the uprising. Not once saying for 60 years this nation was under communist rule and dictatorship that that had anything to do with where they are at this point. That was a ground-shaking moment for Biden to make that statement. It flies in the face of everyone on the progressive left. Many Democrats agree and support him. As I was saying yesterday, there are those who probably were not of age, don't know, never really heard about it. There was another Democrat president who stood up against Cuba and Russia as they began to put missile silos, trying to anyway, in Cuba, just 90 miles from our shores. JFK put up a blockade. He knew then that communism was not going to be good for Cuba, nor for us. But that was the Democrat Party then. Many of those still do exist, but they're also being hijacked or being pulled farther to the left by the likes of AOC. So he had that major admission. A major admission. And there was another major admission yesterday as White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki admitted that the White House is pretty much dictating what goes on Facebook or what doesn't. Let me read her statement. I'm not going to play it, but I did that earlier. If you missed it, go back and catch the podcast for the first hour. But she is saying, and I'm going to read her exact quote here, we're flagging posts for Facebook that spread disinformation. That's not we the people. That's we the White House, we the power, we the ones in control at this point. And Facebook is not meekly going along. They're probably actively going along. Say, what else can we do? Hey, we're ready. What's next? Hey, that Larry Connors USA down there. Let's shut that down. Why not? It's not a big deal, but let's shut it down before it gets big. Squash it now. Whatever your political stripe, if you believe in this country and the Constitution, you know that is a clear violation of the First Amendment. The First Amendment: Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof or abridging the freedom of speech or of the press or the right of the people peaceably to assemble and to petition the government for redress of grievances. Freedom of the press? Only if you go along with what the big tech companies consider proper and accurate speech. And now we get clear indication, whatever the White House and those in control decide. Freedom of speech? No, again, the same thing. Especially if you're trying to rely on the big tech social media world we have today. I would expect, I know, and you do too, in communist China, North Korea, folks are getting anything on any kind of internet or any kind of broadcast source, it is monitored, censored, shut down. I expect that in communist countries. And in Cuba, they've done it. President Biden saying, I'm going to try to get an internet reestablished for them. But he hasn't said he's going to do it for Americans who have been shut down. These are vital. That's another ground-shaking event. Admitting the White House is telling Facebook, we're flagging this, you need to make sure it comes down, and comes down fast. So much for the First Amendment. What's next? Oh, that would be the Second Amendment. As always, I thank you for listening. Spread the word. We're here for you. We're here for patriots. We are 100% patriotic. In fact, remember our pledge, one nation under God.
This is Larry Connors USA.
Larry Connors USA.
Thank you for listening to Larry Connors USA. Please listen to previous and future podcasts.